All right. So considering this typical exam question, where we are given on question number 8, want to see how you're supposed to answer this type of a question. 8.1, we have got a diagram that you're given, and from that you're given that DA is parallel to BC. As we can see the indication there of the parallel lines, and you are asked to determine with reasons without using a protractor, meaning do not measure anything here. All right, so you're asked to find the size of these angles and so forth. So let us see what we are given. The first question, which is 4 marks for that to find x. If you are to consider you are not to measure these angles, all right, then we have got this indication here. All right, this one and this one. Sometimes they will also give you that BA is equal to AC. They are not given. You're supposed to know it from this, from this indication. It shows us that these two lines are equal. All right. So in this case, let us see what we can do. Since BA is equal to AC, that is, we are given this. We are not proving anything here. This part we are already given. It shows us that this angle at C is going to be 63 degrees. Why? Remember that the angles opposite these sides must be equal also. All right. So they are angles, this angle C and this angle B, opposite to what? To the sides which are equal. So this side to this angle, this side to this angle, those angles are supposed to be equal. So it follows that angle C is also equal to 63 degrees, which is actually equal to angle B. Let us just say equal to angle B, which is equal to angle of 63 degrees. That is, we are simply referring to the angles opposite equal sides. So these are angles. You can also write in short angles opposite, all right, equal sides. So you are referring from what? From the equal sides, meaning to say this is 63 degrees. All right. How is this going to help us to find X? Remember that from the concept of a triangle, if the moment that you extend a line like this, you form an exterior angle from an interior angle. So we do understand that this exterior angle, X, is supposed to be equal to the sum of the opposite interior angles, the sum of the opposite interior angles, which means 63 plus 63 degrees. Remember the concept that I explained before. If this is A, this is B, this is C, A plus B is equal to C, or C is equal to A plus B. That is the exterior angle. There we are simply talking of the exterior angle, that is the exterior angle of a triangle. In that case, I'm just going to write in short. If you are given the exterior angle of a triangle, it is equal to the sum of the opposite interior angles. You add those two. Thus, you have angle X. So simply, it was going to be 126 degrees. All right. So we have got the value of X here, which is 126 degrees. All right, that's 4 marks for that. Let's see question 8.12, which is the value of Y in that case, which is 2 marks. All right, how can we determine or have the value of Y? If we are to consider these two lines are parallel and there we are forming a Z alternate angles, we are forming a Z. Remember this. So, meaning to say, this is going to be 63 degrees. Remember that alternate angles are equal. So, in that case, Y was straightforward. Y is equal to angle B, which is ABC. It is equal to angle B, which is equal to 63 degrees. These are alternate angles. So, there you are referring to alternate angles. Since AD is parallel to BC, just like that. So that was straightforward. That's 2 marks for that. Then also as a consideration of 8.2, just to revise, you are given a sketch, and in this sketch, you are given that in this sketch below, which angle of these two represents an angle of depression, an angle of depression between this point and this point. Remember, the angle of depression, you are supposed to be from a higher point looking to the ground. So the angle at B is the angle of depression, where we are looking down to the ground. Okay, so that is the angle ABC. That is, we are considering angle ABC from A to B to C. This angle that is from the point C looking upwards like this, it is now the angle of elevation, meaning to say B, C, D is the angle of elevation. B, C, D is referred to as the angle of elevation. There we are considering from the ground looking to the top. Depression from the top looking to the ground. So that is the idea of this. All right, so these are the typical exam questions that you must consider in your revisions. You must consider revising as much questions as you can from these exam questions. Till we meet again.